Hello everybody, welcome back to Umineko. It's Lorelei, and the last time we left off, we saw a different side of Jessica, as well as Beatrice, and Kanon, if you consider him not wearing his servant's uniform, a different side of him, which I do. But anyway, I'm excited to see how this episode will unfold, so without further ado, let's just get right into it.
どういう意味ですか、ジョージさん。言葉通りの意味だよ。僕はまだ自分の城を築き上げてない。それができて初めて僕は一人前になれたと思えるんだ。その時、君と結婚したい。Oh
my goodness. I mean, I'm still feeling really conflicted about their relationship, because in the beginning, before I knew what Shannon did, I was very happy for them. But then Shannon did what she did, and well, I don't know how much of their relationship is influenced by Beatrice's magic and how much of it is truly genuine, because I mean, Beatrice did say that if without her intervention, George's and Shannon's relationship was never gonna be possible, and in fact will end in tragedy, which I guess it did based on episode 1.
それはその、でもそれじゃもう僕の心が許せないんだ。だから君に婚約指輪を贈りたい。
でもその、私、家具ですし。そうだったね。じゃあ、家具は人の言うことを聞かないとね。今、君に贈るのにふさわしい指輪を作らせてる。多分、今度の親族会議の日には持っていけると思う。その時に贈るから、どうか君の返事を聞かせてほしいんだ。
And this family conference that's coming up soon is, I guess, the one that took place in episode 1.
君が僕の婚約を受けてくれたら、僕はその席でおじい様を含めた全ての親族の前で君との婚約を宣言する。ジョージさん。君と僕の仲をふさわしくないと咎める人たちはきっといる。でも、 そいつらの顔を見る必要はない。君はその瞳の中に僕だけを満たしていればいいから。Sorry,
I laughed a bit because it's kind of cheesy.
君を必ず幸せにする。それだけは絶対に約束するから。
Oh my goodness.
どのように実るのか、楽しみでならない。熟れにすぎて腐り落ちる果実の液に黄金の蝶たちは舞い降り、今より収穫の日が待ち遠しい。宴の時はまだか、まだか。
Oh my god, banquet, and this soundtrack, this music is kind of creepy too. Oh man. October 4th, 1986. Is this the first day of episode 1? Yes, right? They had eaten breakfast at a coffee shop in the station building. By chance, the inside of the shop had been decorated with Halloween colors since it was October. It seemed that Maria had really taken a liking to that. ever since. She had been making a fuss inside the train about wanting to have a Halloween festival without caring that she was attracting the attention of others. Halloween is popular in Europe and America, but people are hardly familiar with it at all in Japan. The shopping district was colorfully decorated with orange pumpkins, but the costume parades of children demanding sweets and saying trick or treat were nowhere in sight. While it wasn't completely full inside the train, there were enough people here that almost all of the seats were occupied. Among them, Maria was making a fuss, kicking her feet back and forth in her seat while Rosa scowled at her. Rosa had told her many times in a low voice to stop, but Maria was taking no notice whatsoever. Once Maria gets this way, no matter how much you try to explain the situation or calm her, she doesn't listen. In the past, Rosa used to pamper Maria and give in to her at times like this. But that had probably been the problem. Almost certainly, the young Maria had formed the wrong impression that if she kept complaining noisily, her mother would give in and listen to her. That error had been brought to Rosa's attention through an educational book, and since then, she had hardened her heart so as not to pamper her beloved daughter. But Rosa could manage less and less mutual understanding with Maria, and it had become more and more common that she felt discouraged by her own powerlessness. As Maria kicked her feet, a stout old woman sitting in a seat across from Maria picked a candy out of her handbag and gave it to her. That's nice. She's cute like this when she's not being scary.
Kora, Maria.
Oh my god. That's a very scary expression from Rosa. Why? Laughing like Kumasawa too.
Genki na ojousan desu koto. Oikutsu desu?
There may not have been any malice in those words from the old woman, but it seemed that Rosa had taken that in an extremely humiliating way.
Maria! Oh!
Oh, I know what's gonna happen. I think Rosa's gonna wrestle it out of Maria's hands. I feel like I've seen this play out in real life quite a few times already, and it really does not end well. I really don't like this kind of parenting.
Mama no yukoto o kikete itsumo itteru desho!
Maria no!
Oh god.
その you know やめなさいって言ってるでしょ!
Rosa reflexively hit Maria violently on her cheek. See, that's a problem. I mean, hitting her is one thing. Hitting her violently is another. But anyway, I shall stop making comments like this. In a flash, Maria started crying loudly. Rosa immediately snatched the candy from Maria's hand and stuck it out towards the dumbfounded old woman sitting next to them.
うちの子に勝手にお菓子を与えないでください!
ごめんなさい!
Oh man. Breathing heavily, Rosa once again held the candy out to the old woman. The old woman looked confused for a moment about what she should say, but then understood that perhaps her actions may have caused trouble for this parent and child, and she accepted the candy back, apologizing. Then, Rosa finally took notice of her surroundings. Her daughter's clothes were all messed up. She was crying and shouting with her nose dripping. And there were many dumbfounded passengers watching them. Except for the sound of the train running, the rail car was completely silent. Fortunately, that pitiful silence didn't last more than a short while. However, in its place came an even more painful atmosphere as everyone whispered. Maria shouted, cried, kicked and stomped her feet as usual, paying no heed to the people sitting around her. Impulsively, Rosa tried to slap her again. No, why? But she noticed the cold eyes of the people in the train and couldn't do that anymore. When the train stopped, Rosa got off, forcibly pulling Maria by the arm and almost dragging her along the ground. Oh, come on. This is really painful for me. As usual, Maria didn't stop crying. Rosa took her to the end of the platform and hit her cheek again. At the moment she was hit, Maria stopped crying for an instant. But before long, she shouted and cried even more than before. Rosa, whose emotions had exploded, grabbed Maria by her collar and pulled her hair as if to rip it out. Ah, my heart breaks for Maria. Oh my god, please stop hitting your child!
そのうーを!やめなさいって言ってるでしょ!そんなんだからクラスにお友達ができないんでしょ!もっとしっかりしてよ!なんであんたはいつまでも頭の中が幼稚園なのよ!どうしてママの言うことが聞けないの!どうして!どうして!
Along with those severe words, Rosa hit Maria's head over and over again. The more Maria cried and shouted, the more Rosa hit her. And the more Maria was hit, the more intensely she cried and shouted. Oh my god. I'm really crying right now. And it's so sad because to Maria, Rosa is her only safe haven. That's the only thing I can think of. But Rosa is the only person that Maria can rely on. And that's why, God, that's why even though Rosa is the one hitting Maria and causing her all this pain, she's also the only person that Maria can ask for help from. I'm not ready for this.
そのうーをどうしてやめられないの?あんたがそんなんだから友達ができないのよ!あんたがそんなんだからパパの出張が終わらないのよ! あんたがそんなんだから私が。
あのお客さんいかがされましたか。
何かご用ですか。
The one who timidly called out to her was the station attendant. Rosa glared at him with a look that said, "Don't cut into the problems of a mother and child, stranger." And that's the unfortunate thing, right? That many people don't interfere because they think that it's a family issue and they don't want to interfere with it. And that's how things like this happen too.The station attendant surely hadn't wanted to talk to her. However, Rosa had been yelling on the platform for a much longer time than she had imagined. Her emotional scolding had caused the passengers on the platform to advise the station attendant that it would be a good idea to speak to her. Rosa yelled at the station attendant that they would get on the next train and not to bother them anymore. And then, finally,Or maybe we should say, for the second time, she noticed the passengers on the platform staring at her from the distance. Rosa sweated slightly. She felt the wind chill the sweat, tormenting her. Maria was still crying, shielding her own head. Oh. No, unless this beating stopped, she would probably keep crying forever.As Rosa recovered from the evil heat inside her head, she knew she had surrendered her soul to something bad again.
Mama! 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 帰ってきて!
Rosa fell to her knees and hugged Maria, whose face was all soggy with tears and mucus.It's clear that Rosa definitely needs a therapist. Both of them need help.
Mama! Mama! Okaeri! Okaeri!
Finally, Maria realized that her mother had turned back to being her mother. Then she clung to her mother's body and cried,Burying her face in her mother's chest.
悪いママを許して。悪いママを許して。本当にごめんなさい。ママをどうか嫌いにならないで。
マリアは全然平気。ママを嫌いになんかならない。ママはまた悪い魔女に乗り移られていただけ。でも、ママが帰ってきたから平気。
I hate that Maria has to go through this. As such a young child, too.
悪い魔女に、ママはまた乗り移られていたの。ごめんね。本当にごめんね。
For a long time, the two of them hugged each other, asking for forgiveness and sending words of forgiveness back. After a while, the two of them gradually calmed down and naturally drew their faces apart. Maria's face, Rosa's face, both were deep red after crying their eyes out.
ハロウィンのお祭りがしたいの。
うん。ジョージお兄ちゃんやジェシカお姉ちゃんにカボチャマシュマロを見せてあげたかった。
That was a sweet which had been alongside the cash register at the shop where they had eaten breakfast. It was a fancy suite that had a big orange marshmallow in the shape of a jack-o'-lantern stuck on the end of a stick. Maria had wanted that and had insistently pestered for it. Rosa had disallowed it, saying that there was no way she would buy such a suite right after they'd had breakfast.
じゃあ、マリア。この町に売っているかどうかわからないけど、降りて探してみようか。
お、
Maria's even making an effort here not to say her trademark words.
ママ大好き、愛してる。ありがとう。
私もよ、マリア。愛してるわ。
The truth was that they had no time to waste loitering around at a stopover station. If they missed the airplane, they would fall half a day behind schedule. She would have left home with more time to spare, but she had ended up leaving late after spending too long choosing Maria's clothes. I just want to say that Rosa definitely reminds me of someone, and that's probably why their relationship is quite personal to me. Because of that, Rosa had been a bit impatient since the morning. She looked at the clock. They should be getting on the next train immediately. But her daughter had firmly joined hands with her to go buy the sweet together, and that hand was warm. To Rosa right now, it was more important to regrow her bonds with Maria. Maria was not only Rosa's beloved daughter, she was everything Rosa had. Fortunately, she could see that there was a big supermarket right in front of the station. Maybe she wouldn't be able to find a suite exactly like that one, but Maria would probably accept something similar. Besides, Rosa also couldn't show up with a face swelled from crying. She would have to fix her makeup.
あれと全く同じマシュマロは見つからないかもしれないけど、似たようなお菓子があるといいね。それで、いとこのみんなを一緒に驚かそうね。
I don't remember if they actually found a sweet in episode 1, because I can't remember Maria showing off anything.
うん。ママと一緒に買うお菓子なら何でもいい。
The two left the turnstiles of the station in this unknown town. Maria walked across the pedestrian crossing together with her mother, feeling very pleased, as though she was walking in an amusement park. Both faces were still deep red, but warmth could be seen between the two of them, mother and child, as they smiled at each other awkwardly.
あなた、こんなところでどうされたのですか?
I guess this chapter is going to show us what took place before they ended up at the family conference.
キミコ、何でもない。考え事をするのにここが少し心地よかっただけだ。
今日の準備は全て手配が終わっています。あとはお茶でも飲みながら。くつろいで待とうではありませんか。
すまん。君にいつも面倒なことをすべて押し付けている。
どうか、私をもっと頼ってはいただけませんか。私はあなたの妻です。
無論君にはいつも助けられているし、感謝もしている。だからこそ、私は私の仕事に専念できる。
わかっています。お仕事のこと、そしてお父様の遺産の話ですね。
君には関係のないことだ。欲深な兄弟たちの腐肉の漁り合いに過ぎ。
大丈夫です、あなた。すべてうまくいきます。
This is so ominous.
あなたのお仕事がうまくいかなかったことはありません。
Natsuhi softly cuddled close to Krauss's shoulder. She spoke words to reward Krauss for the difficulties of his work, but Natsuhi was herself the one who knew best that it wasn't going well. Krauss's enterprises were something like a seesaw where large amounts of money swung. A big investment leads to a large return. But the swaying of a large-scale seesaw is large yet sluggish, and not something which shows immediate results. At times, he would make more investments so that the seesaw inclined faster towards the good side. Naturally, he did that because he had the confidence that, in a not-so-distant future, he would be able to recover all the investments he made. However, the seesaws Krauss chose never turned out as he would have liked them too. His foresight wasn't wrong, but times were slow. They never caught up with him. For example, think of a literal seesaw placed in a park. Due to its great popularity, there was always someone playing on it. So if he wanted to play, he would have to wait a long time for his turn. And then, one day, he found that seesaw vacant, straddled it, realizing he was the first to arrive, and had it all to himself. However, nobody got on the opposite side of that seesaw, so he couldn't play on it. And no matter how much time had passed, nobody came to the opposite side of the seesaw. The seesaw is a popular piece of playground equipment, so if you waited, another person would definitely show up. Krauss noticed. The weather looked like it was getting worse. That's why nobody was coming outside to play. But the seesaw is a popular piece of playground equipment, so someone would definitely come. If he vacated his place because the weather seemed to be getting worse, someone would definitely snatch his place away. And he would end up only longingly gazing from a distance at someone else having fun playing on the seesaw again. On one side of the seesaw, he continued to wait patiently, all alone. That was Krauss's current enterprise and situation.
ええ、そうです。あなたの先見性はいつも間違っていません。あなただけがお父様の才覚を受け継いだのです。他の兄弟たちが誰も受け継がなかった天性のものを受け継がれた。なのに、私はそれを信じられず、いつも臆病に自らの事業を畳んできた。なぜ自分を信じることができないのか。 自分を信じられない男を誰が信じる？誰も信じない。私はいつも敗者の座るべき椅子に自ら座り、親父にもお袋にも兄弟たちにも笑われる。私はいつになったらこのコンプレックスから解放されるのだ。いつになったら。
Only Natsuhi knew. She knew of Krauss's anguish. As the eldest son of the Yoshinomiya family, who would have to shoulder a big responsibility, he couldn't open his pained heart to anyone and would always be compared to his father's great enterprises.
あなたが親族会議に専念できるよう、すべての手配を済ませています。すべて。すまん。親父殿の件は…
What does that mean?
はい。源氏と南條先生は私たちの味方です。
Wait, what? What does that mean? Oh my god.
あの強欲な兄弟たちを決してお父様には会わせません。
This feels like a very significant development. What does it mean that Genji and Nanjo are on their side?
もしもし? Hi, Goda desu.
Goda, the guy with the most punchable face so far.
Omakase kudasai.
I have a particular dislike for this face of his. Mostly because he looks so entitled. He has this arrogant expression on. I think I'm going too much about how much I hate Goda, so I will stop here.
年に一度の大仕事に腕が鳴っております。
Ingredients of varied colors had been gathered in the kitchen, and the preliminary arrangements had already been started. Even though it was still morning, the ingredients for dinner was already in saucepans and steaming. Whoa. Normally, he had to deal with several assorted matters other than cooking, but on a day of the family conference, he could devote himself to it entirely. To Goda, who was originally a chef, this was surely the greatest gala occasion of the whole year.
ええ、ディナーには子牛のステーキを。素晴らしい肉がすでに惚れ子で、今夜を待ちわびておりますよ。まかないも今夜はぜひ期待してください。
It was rare for Goda to be in this good of a mood towards his fellow servants. To Goda, who boasted about being a chef who worked exclusively for the Ushiromiya family, being given the right to show off his cooking at the family conference was the greatest honor.
Wakatta. Makaseru node yoroshiku tanomu. Ato, Kumasawa ga sochira ni inai ka?
Kumasawa-san desu ka?
Oh, through the phone.
Sakihodo mikakemashita ga, kochira ni wa orimasen.
ゲストハウスの方へ準備に行かれたのではないでしょうか。また油を売っているのか。いや、結構だ。では引き続きよろしく頼む。ええ、万事、このゴーダにお任せを。Genji placed the telephone back on the receiver, sighing lightly. Thinking of Kumasawa, who was no doubt hiding and slacking off even though things were this busy. And the ostentatious Goda, who only felt like doing anything on a day when he could show off. Genji sighed once again.
失礼します。ゲストハウスの各お部屋の準備が整いました。お嬢様より、お子様方が泊まれるよう、4人分の用意をするようにとのご指示を賜りましたが、いかがいたしましょう?
Wait. Four people. At the guest house, even though it should have been for the rest of them, right? The entire other side of the family? I don't know if I'm just recalling things wrong, but this could be interesting.
今年は6年ぶりにバトラ様がお見えになるそうだ。お嬢様もいとこ4人で夜更かしをされたいのだろう。 準備するように奥様にはお伝えしなくてよい。Wait,
get what ready? This is creepy.
そうですね。かしこまりました。Maybe
he just means the rooms, right? Right?
今夜は深夜勤で、そのまま明日は早朝勤か。しんどい2日間になりそうだな。そういえば、
台風が直撃するって天気予報で言っていますね。大丈夫でしょうか?
台風がよほどそれない限り、場合によっては親族の皆様方のお帰りの船に響くだろう。親族会議の日程が月曜か火曜あたりまで長引くかもしれない。長丁場になるだろうが、皆くれぐれも 粗相のないように頼む。シャノンは焦らぬようお落ち着いて。カノンは愛想よくご挨拶をするように。あ、はい。注意します。注意します。大切なお客様がお越しになられる日だ。くれぐれも粗相がないように。Today?
Extremely important guest? Very important guest?
心得ています。いつだって。ここには大切なお客様しか訪れませんから。
カノン、今日は本当の意味で大切なお客様を迎える。
Beatrice, right?
心構えを改めるように。
はい。
シャノン、どうした？
I think I need time to piece together what they've said, which I probably will do after I edit this video. But everything is very interesting right now.Because it seems like they know that Beatrice is gonna visit the house today. Which means that there must be plans set in motion already for Beatrice to come. Well, but I don't really know what the conditions are for Beatrice to appear. And she did talk about a banquet as well, so there's that. I think we'll only learn more as we go along the story.
さっきから何かそわそわしているようだが、何か時間の約束でもあるのか？
え？いえ、何でもありません。失礼いたしました。
姉さん、今日は大切なお客様がお越しになる日なんだよ。プライベートとは切り離すようにね。
プライベートなんか知りません。
I should have blushed just a little bit.She turned her gaze away from the clock. Was it about time for the airplane carrying the family to arrive at Nijima? She had thought she had been hiding the fact that her long-awaited reunion with George was making her heart palpitate, but Kanon, who stood at her side, understood her perfectly.
シャノン、これを黙って受け取ってくれ。
I'm sorry. The location is very suspicious. Isn't this like a restroom or something? I knew it. Inside a bathroom stall, George was practicing something over and over, taking out a small velvet box hidden in his pocket like a quick draw desert gunman.
違うな。シャノンは牽引力のある男性が好きなんだ。もっと馬力がある感じじゃないとダメだ。シャノン、これを薬指につけるんだ。命令だよ。ああ、左手とちゃんと言わないと右手にされちゃうかもしれない。いや、シャノンもそこまでかまととじゃないけど。ああ、でも少しは自由意志がないとなんだかその。
George seems like a very, nice guy. Which makes this whole thing feel even worse. Because I like George. And I like Shannon. But now I don't know whether I like Shannon anymore. Because of what she did.Well, we will see, as all things, we will see. As he crossed his arms, moaning and groaning, someone knocked on the door. George was startled back to reality.
Oh, George-kun. 大丈夫か?
I was thinking it would be Battler, but this is the closest person to Battler right now.
腹の調子でも悪いのか?
Rudolph, you're telling me you didn't hear George speaking for like 10 minutes straight out loud in the bathroom?
Rudolph, oji-san. 大丈夫です。平気です。ご心配は無用です。
そっか。ならいいんだけどね。無理して生き見すぎるなよ。尻が切れちまうぜ。
Oh my god. Rudolph washed his hands, laughing cheerfully, and left. George knew that the most embarrassing part hadn't been overheard, and he patted his chest in relief.
Kyrie, Rosa はまだ来ないのか?
まだよ。遅いわね。
I kinda miss seeing their faces, for real.
天候調整中だからいいようなものを。これで普段通りのダイヤだったらあいつ、乗り遅れちまうぜ。
Yeah, I remember they were late, so I guess they really did go and find candy.
そしたらどうする気なんだあいつ。
ローザさんだっていい年の大人よ。なんとかするわ。兄って人はいくつになっても妹を子供扱いなのね。
親父だっていくつになっても子供だけどな。
だと？俺が子供ならおめえは赤ん坊じゃねえか。ほれほれバトラちゃん、高い高い。
This is so funny.
やめろ、くすぐって。やめ。
He really tried to pick Battler up?
親子ってより悪ガキ仲間って感じね。ほら、いらしたわよ。
おーおーおー、ローザさんやないか。マリアちゃん、久しぶりやの。
久しぶり。
マリア、お久しぶりです。でしょ？行ってごらん。
おー、お久しぶりです。
そうや。
I remember that. She corrected Maria, but I always feel like this part is more of a strict mother kind of thing and nothing to...I mean, her relationship with Maria is definitely very, very unhealthy. But you can't really sense that here, at least for me.
よく言えたな。ご褒美に飴玉あげような。
おっと、あれ？どこにしまったんや？
ローザさん、お久しぶりです。マリアちゃんもお久しぶり。
ご無沙汰してます、キリエ姉さん、秀吉兄さん。
あら、バトラ君？
大きくなったわね。
いやー、今日は会うたびに言われてて恥ずかしいっすよ。
おう、ローザ、遅かったな。飛行機がダイヤ通りだったらギリギリってとこだったぜ。
ごめんなさい、列車の接続がうまくいかなくて。
何？また天候調査中なの？
ぼやかないぼやかない。船で6時間も揺られるくらいなら飛行機でほんの30分の方がずっとマシよ。たとえ1時間余計に待たされたって全然早いんだから。
あれがマリアなのか。大きくなったな。成長期か。
前に会ったのは6年前？それは変わるわよ。女は心変わりがあればたった1日でも生まれ変わる生き物よ。
That's rich coming from you, Rosa. Maria noticed a big man who she didn't remember mixed among the relatives and hid behind Rosa's back, glaring at Battler.
おいバトラ、挨拶しろい。前に会ったのが3歳の時じゃ。初対面も同じだぞ。
3歳じゃ覚えてねえよな。よっマーリア、久しぶり。大きくなったな。
マリア、バトラお兄ちゃんよ。ルドルフおじさんの息子さん、わかる？
おじさんの息子さんが、おじさんが息子さん。はあ、
He's your cousin. It's complicated. She was obviously on her guard. She must have found it frightening for a large guy like Battler to suddenly start speaking frankly to her. Battler noticed that as well and thought of various ways he might approach her. Then he noticed the sweet she had in her hand. Oh, so they did buy the sweet. It was the jack-o'-lantern sweet that Rosa had bought for her.
So か。10月だからハロウィンか。お菓子をくれなきゃいたずらしちゃうぞ。
If you try to take a treat from a small child, normally you expect them to cry and start a fuss. The adults thought that method wasn't good, but surprisingly, Maria looked pleased, her face splitting into a wide grin.
もうハロウィン知ってる。ほらほら、
こーら、バトラお兄ちゃんと呼びなさい。
ごめんね、バトラ君。
いやいや、気にしないっすよ。俺はバトラと呼んでくれ。俺も、マリアって呼ぶからな。ほら、マリア、ハロウィンだぞ。お菓子をくれなきゃ、いたずらしちゃうぞ。
お菓子をくれなきゃ、いたずらしちゃうぞ。
From inside her handbag, Maria picked out a jack-o'-lantern sweet identical to the one she had in her hand and presented it to Battler. It seemed that Battler accepting it was enough to confirm their friendship. The adults felt admiration at how children have their own ways of communicating. To Maria, who had been complaining that she wanted to have a Halloween festival, it must have felt like Battler was a friend since he knew about trick or treat. Her defensive posture from before was completely gone. Now she was all merry as though they had been friends for decades.
そうだな。日本じゃハロウィンってマイナーなイベントだよな。仮装行列で練り歩くなんて、向こうのニュースではよく見るけど、日本じゃ見たことないぜ。
マリアも仮装したかった。仮装して、いとこみんなでお菓子をくれなきゃいたずらしちゃうぞってやりたかった。
そっかそっか。今度俺と一緒にやろうな。マリアだったら、何の仮装をして練り歩きたい？
A witch.
魔女！ベアトリーチェ！
I'm expecting something. And nothing.
おや、お嬢様、こんなところに。奥様が探しておいででしたよ。
探されたくねえからこんなところにいるんだぜ。どうせ、身なりは大丈夫かとか、言葉遣いをちゃんとするようにとか。おこごとが言いたいだけに違いないぜ。
違いありません。
私はさ、なぜか親族会議の日になるとこの魔女様が気になるんだよ。
ほう、それはまたどうしてでございましょう。
親族会議ってのは、じい様に連なる全ての一族老頭が集まる日だ。今年は6年ぶりにバトラも来るそうじゃねえか。そんな感じでさ、何十年かぶりに今までずっと姿を現さなかった親族がひょっこりと現れるんじゃないかっていつも思ってるんだよ。
ほほう、そんな親族がおりますでしょうか。
ベアトリーチェ様だよ。素性は誰も知らない、あるいは大昔のじい様の愛人なのか。その子孫がひょっこりと現れて、授けた黄金を返せなんて言い出すかもしれないぜ。
クラウス様たちは、親方様の遺産問題で、今年も議論されるでしょうから。こうも魔女の黄金の話で盛り上がっては、黄金を与えた魔女本人が、そろそろおいでになってもおかしくありませんね。
熊沢さんはさ、辞めたり勤めたりと忙しいけど、源氏さん並みに昔からここに出入りしてるわけでしょ。ベアトリーチェのこともっと知ってるんじゃないの。
さてと。思い出そうにもこの老いぼれ、今朝の朝食すらも思い出せませんので。
熊沢さんはいっつもそういう言い方で逃げるけど、何か知ってそうなんだよな。知ってて物陰で笑ってるみたいな陰湿な雰囲気が時々するぜ。
I feel the same way too. Like a bit.
これは手厳しい。隠し事など何もしておりません。私から申し上げられることは、ベアトリーチェ様は黄金の魔女であられて、この島の夜を支配されているもう一人の主人であられるということだけでございます。
じい様の受け売りかよ。給料もらってるとはいえ、じい様の妄言に付き合うのも大変だな。
ただこれだけは申し上げられます。
何？ロ
ッケン島は太古の昔、小豆島と呼ばれて恐れられてきました。小豆は悪食がなまったものと言われ、本当は悪食島と呼ばれていたのだと、漁民たちの間では伝えられておりました。
Oh my god. Evil Appetite Island.
前にも聞いたよ。この辺は暗礁が多くて、海難事故が多かったから、漁民たちが恐れてむやみに近づかなかったって話だろ？
悪食島には悪霊が住み着いていて、太古の昔から人々の魂を喰らい続けてきました。この島に関わり、命を奪われた人間はあまりにも多いのです。
それを旅の修験者だかなんだかが、例の社を作って鎮魂したんで収まったってんじゃなかったっけ？
Isn't this the place where Namira was at?
うさんくせえ話だぜ。
その鎮魂の社はこの夏、暗き闇を引き裂く紫色の不気味な雷で打ち砕かれたとか。
熊沢さん、その話好きだな。確かに鎮魂の社が落雷でなくなっちまうなんて不気味だが、まあもともとオンボロだったしな。ちょっと高い波にでもさらわれたんじゃねえのかな。
眠りから目覚めた悪食島の悪霊がベアトリーチェ様を呼び寄せたのです。もしベアトリーチェ様が親族会議に訪れられるようなことがあったなら。
あったなら。
Umasawa kept silent for a moment there. Jessica, who wanted her to keep going, found that silence very eerie. Once Kumasawa was satisfied that she had spooked Jessica just to write him out, she grinned broadly.
はてさて、どんなことになるやら。
へえ、そいつは素敵じゃないかよ。
でしょ？たまには優雅な時間を得て、あなたの心を豊かにするのも、あなたの仕事に役に立つんじゃないかしら。
だな。心と財布は豊かじゃなきゃいけねえ。わかったよ。その日は開けておくことにする。予約を頼むぜ。
わかったわ。絶対よ。
ああ、よろしく頼む。愛してるぜ、キリエ。
After kissing the receiver, Rudolph hung up. This just sounds so like him to do that. In front of his seat, there were many executives with their sleeves rolled up, eagerly awaiting the end of that phone call. Oh my goodness.
すまん、待たせたぜ。アメリカから連絡は来たか？
はい。外線にデイル渡辺弁護士からです。おつなぎします。
結局のところ、感触はどうなんだ？
それがその、一つ芳しくないようでして、先方は裁判をも辞さないつもりのようです。
やっぱりごまかしきれねえかな。繋いでくれ。
わかりました。すぐに。
The executive ordered the secretarial office to connect him to the external line. Immediately, the telephone in front of Rudolph started ringing.
もしもし。ハロー、ハロー。お待たせしました。後ろ宮です。どうもどうも。いかがですか、そちらは。
Hello, President 後ろ宮。挨拶は抜きで本題に入りましょう。いいニュースと悪いニュースがありますが、どちらを先にしますか？
悪いニュースが先がいいな。デザートがないと頑張れないたちなんだ。
わかりました。悪いニュースは、先方が東方を告発する準備に入ったということです。つい先日、類似した裁判で原告が圧勝する判決が出されました。被告側も当方が主張するのとほぼ同じ内容で論戦していたのですが、全てにおいて却下されました。残念ながらこのまま法廷に臨めば当方の主張はことごとく却下される可能性が極めて高いでしょう。
例の裁判、全滅だったか、うちより有利な条件だったと思ってたんだが、そりゃ辛いな。で、いいニュースは？
先方の幹部と接触できました。先方に当方の立ち位置を説明し、先方のブランドイメージを侵害する意図がないことを説明し、理解を得ることができました。先方は近日中に条件提示を行い、それらの履行が行われるなら告発を見送ると約束しました。取締役会のナンバー2による発言です。
感触は？
正直非常に厳しいものになると予想されます。当方の想定では避けられないものとして、社名変更、ブランド名変更、交渉の余地のあるものとして和解金額、大手新聞への謝罪広告掲載、それらの履行期間と見ています。
うちに潰れろと一言言やいいのに、周りくどい奴らだぜ。
先方は近年2代目社長に交代したばかりで、まだ足固めが終わっていません。当方が徹底抗戦した場合、現社長に失点を与えたい勢力が何らかの利的工作をしかねないと懸念しています。そのため先方トップも本件を速やかに解決したいという思惑があるようです。そのため迅速な和解のために多少の条件緩和を引き出せる余地も残っているかもしれません。
いずれにせよ、とんでもねえ金が必要になるか。
その覚悟は必要です。そしてそれでも懲罰的賠償金よりははるかに安いかと。
ありがとう先生、また進展があったら連絡してください。先生は高給取りだから、与太話もできねえ。サンキューサンキュー、グッバイ。
Rudolph hung up the phone. It seemed that the executives sitting in the reception seats could guess what had been said.
聞こえたか野郎ども。まあ総じるとだ、金さえ積みや堪忍してやるぜってわけだ。あとは金の高だけを争点にすりゃいい。
しかし社長、渡辺氏の示した和解金の想定額はあまりにも膨大です。それだけの余裕はありません。
こんなことになるって分かってたら、高くかなんて始めんじゃなかったぜ。
3年しのげれば資金的危機は脱出できる計算でした。まさかここで刺されるなんて、本当についてない。
ホップステップジャンプのステップでこけちまったんだもんな。泣けるぜ。
メインバンクから金を引っ張るしかありません。
銀行はまずいな。連中は勝ち馬にしか金を出さん。景気は上向いてるが、銀行に弱みは見せられねえ。
社長、母外に資金はありますか？我々の把握していない資金です。
よせやい。俺がそういう男に見えるかよ。俺の財布の中身は全てお前らに晒してるぜ。そこにある帳簿が我が社の全てだ。
なら金策が必要です。数百万ドル単位を引っ張れるスポンサーが大至急必要です。
And that sponsor is Kinzo.
社長、社長の交友関係で何とかなりませんでしょうか。
社長、社長。
ああ落ち着けてめえら。金策は俺が何とかする。お前らはガタガタせずに業務を維持しろ。金さえ積めば向こうは許すと言ってるんだ。すでに俺たちはアジアに太いパイプを持ってる。いろいろ響くだろうが取引は維持できる。要は金さえ積めりゃ全て解決できる問題なんだ。見てろ、俺が全て解決する。お前らを路頭に迷わせなんかしねえぞ。大船に乗った気でいろい。無事に解決したらお前ら全員をシャンパンタワーでねぎらってやるぜ。約束する。だから黙って俺についてこい。
Rudolph seems reliable, or he speaks as if he is reliable, like I could be in safe hands with him. But then again, his business is kind of failing over here.
いいな。
Ooh, the airplane suddenly shook, probably because of turbulence.That shaking roused Rudolph from his sleep. He had woken up early that morning and had ended up drifting off to sleep while resting in his seat.
大丈夫？まだだいぶ眠いんじゃないの？このところだいぶ仕事が忙しかったようだし。
仕事が忙しいなんて大いに結構じゃねえか。俺が暇になっちまったら、俺たち明日から路頭に迷うぜ。
そうね。バトラ君も帰ってきたんだから、二人で物乞いすればいいって問題じゃないわよ。
そうだな。六年ぶりに家族が揃ったんだからな。家族水入らずで過ごせるよう、課長が頑張らねえとな。
When he looked outside the window, he saw that the airplane was already starting to drop in altitude considerably. The fishing boats, which had only looked like black grains until a short while ago, had become clearly visible.
親父に土下座して、原骨一発で1000万借りられるなら、一ダースくらいもらっときてえところなんだがな。さもなきゃ、とっととお隠れになってくれりゃいいんだが。散々すねをかじって、今度は遺産目当てか。俺は地獄行きだな。
This is ominous.
そりゃこんな俺に親父も会いたくはないだろうよ。
Combined with the fact that he said he was gonna be murdered. Well, I mean, it may not mean anything. Yet. Or ever, actually.
まさか今年も親族会議にお出にならないつもりですかな。
Nanjo looked at Kinzo's face, sighing. Kinzo's eyes remained rooted to those strange magic books.
ハゲタカどもの議論に加わるつもりはない。好きに我が骨のしゃぶり方でも議論するがよかろう。実にくだらぬ。
やれやれ、困ったものですな。
Nanjo shook his head slightly. To him, children and grandchildren were to be adored, and he believed that their growth was the only enjoyment for old men. He found Kinzo's words to be a very sad thing.
この部屋を出るべき時が来れば私は姿を現す。あれが姿を未だ現さぬようにな。
Kinzo raised his face, and in the direction of his gaze was the portrait of the witch, respectfully displayed on the wall. Inside Kinzo's head, there was no conception of today being the day of the family conference, the day where all of his dear family would gather together. There was only the face of the witch in the oil painting, who never smiled outside her portrait.Everybody knew that when Kinzo talked about Beatrice, unnecessarily cutting in would instigate his wrath.
私は今日、ある儀式を執り行う。
それは何ですかな？
儀式というよりは、博打に近い。なぜなら、リスクを負わぬ魔法に奇跡は宿らぬからだ。
Nanjo had already heard this countless times. You could call it Kinzo's favorite phrase. It seemed that Kinzo believed in magic and miracles arising through betting his own fate with a certain kind of risky probability and beating the odds.
かつて黄金のギャンブラーと言われた Kinzo さんが、いつお迎えが来てもおかしくないそのご老体で、一体どんな博打に挑みますやら。これは見ものですな。
なるほど。研究を尽くした秘術の儀式も魔法にたけぬお前にかかれば博打呼ばわりか。まあいい。奇跡を信じる私が勝てば、お前の目には水鏡にしか見えなかったであろう我が研究のすべてが、この日に結実したことをはっきりと理解できるだろう。
So it feels like Kinzo is gonna do something on this day.
お前が勝てば、見たままの通り、いつ迎えが来てもおかしくない年寄りの衰強に終わるだけだ。
ん？一体どんなギャンブルを始めるやら。あなたの友人としてその賭けに、いや、儀式でしたか。その儀式にあなたが勝てるよう心からお祈りするだけです。
うん。感謝する。
そういえば金蔵さん、今年の親族会議には懐かしい客がおられるそうですな。
Oh, maybe he's talking about Butler, but I was thinking of Beatrice.
何？
Kinzo reacted in an unusual way to Nanjo's words and turned around.
ほら、ルドルフさんのところのバトラ君です。6年ぶりにおいでになるそうじゃありませんか。きっと立派になっていますよ。
なんだ、バトラか。
Ah, I knew it. He was thinking about Beatrice too, right? But, it feels like the servants, at least, Kinzo, Genji and Shannon and Kanon knows that perhaps Beatrice is coming?
6年ぶり程度の客人など懐かしいなどと呼びはせぬ。
Upon hearing Battler's name, he showed an ill-humored expression as though he had been let down and turned his back to Nanjo again.
金蔵さんにとっての6年など、この部屋で研究に没頭すればあっという間のことでしょうからな。
本当に懐かしい客は、あるいは訪れるかもしれん。
Now this is definitely about Beatrice.
全てはルーレットの出目次第だ。
He always talks about that roulette, and I think Kanon talked about the roulette in before he died as well. But I don't know what this roulette is.
すでにルーレットは回り始めている。ルージュかノワールか。今宵ルーレットがどんな奇跡を見せてくれるのか楽しませてもらおうではないか。配当は大きいぞ。そして負ける気はせぬ。ベアトリーチェよ、我が賭けを受けるがいい。
Just then, the telephone on the table rang. That piercing noise seemed to displease Kinzo, and he picked up the receiver in order to preserve the silence as much as he could.
何事か？私は忙しい。
現地でございます。親族の皆様方が到着なされました。
だからどうしたというのだ。
I knew he would say that.
適当に茶でも出せばよい。
かしこまりました。そのようにいたします。
Kinzo hung up the phone rudely. Watching him, Nanjo sighed yet again and shifted his attention outside the window. As he was now, Kinzo would probably show no interest in any kind of guest. Was there any guest who could make Kinzo agree to come out when he should? Beatrice, of course. He had one person in mind,But that guest was one who could not possibly appear. After a glance at the witch of the portrait and her candid expression, which he could not place as happy or sad, Nanjo gazed up at the leaden sky. Ooh. It's Beatrice.Of course it is. Oh, it's tea party. Now then, are the pieces all lined up? Let us start a new game with the pieces all lined up once more.
何か問題は？
ねえよ。
Battler?The witch looked at him in challenge while elegantly smoking her pipe. And Battler? He just slovenly shrugged his shoulders as though she wasn't worth his time. He wouldn't look her in the eyes. But that didn't mean he wasn't gonna play. It signified his plain determination to never be taken in by the artifices of this being he faced. It was an expression of his powerful determination to fight.
Masaka. Musaku dewa arumai na.
Omae no dekata ga wakaranei ijou, saku mo nani mo nee ze. Suki ni sente o toreba ii janei ka.
Mochiron sou sasete itadaku zo. Omae no mamori o ika ni kuzusu ka, nante de tsumeru ka. Warawa no ude no misedokoro yo.
Omae ga donna te de koyou ga, ore wa omae o shinjinai. Sono itten o ore ga tsuranuki tousu kagiri, ore ni make wa nai. Te koto wa da, kono geemu wa omae ni katenai you ni dekite ru ze.
Sou kamoshiren. Shikashi na, geemu o nando kurikaesu ka wa warawa ga kimeru zo. Soshite warawa ga kachi.
That's hardly a game.
Tsumari kore wa sainami yo. Sonata ga warawa ni kuppuku suru made tsuzuku eien no sainami. Sonata ga warawa wo majo no sonzai wo mitomeru made eien ni tsuzuku.
Nara, ore mo omae ga konmake suru made nando demo mugen ni tsukiyatte yaru ze.
But she is the witch of endlessness, right?
どこぞの魔女にでも入れ知恵されたか? まあよい。
コタクは聞き飽きたぜ。さあ、おっ始めやがれ!
さあ、始めようではないか。そなたの指し手はすでに知り尽くしておる。手の内を知られた守りなど、たかが知れておる。同じ手でしのぎきれると思うでないぞ。
ベアトリーチェ、一つだけ、最初に言っておくことがある。
なんだ。
お前が何をのたまおうと自由だ。だが、俺が信じるかどうか、常に、俺が自分で決める。貴様の魔法がどれほどのものだったとしても、俺の魂は屈しない。これは俺への拷問だと?違うね!
ならば何だというのか?
これはお前への拷問なのさ!
もう!
お前がいつ俺に屈し、諦めるか!それまで繰り返される拷問なのさ!
Go, Battler, go!
面白いかな?その例えやよし!互いを苛み合う拷問とは実に面白い。さーて、始めようではないか。後ろ宮バトラ
ー Damn. Oh my. We have to clock back.Guest of honor. Okay, okay, but wait. I'm guessing. Are they gonna play this game from that tea party room? I really want to see how this plays out. I don't know what they mean still by a game. But anyway, yes, let's continue. Every year, the relatives who visit Rokkenjima let out a sigh of admiration at the rose garden which first greets them.They stood there talking with each other about the roses' beauty and state of their blooming this year. There was a single unhealthy rose among them, and Maria became overwhelmed with dejection at its state. But George used his quick wits and saying she should look after it if she felt that sorry for it, he marked it with a candy wrapper and immediately restored Maria's good mood. Oh, okay, now I remember the candy wrapper, okay. And once Battler, with whom she had been getting along well all morning, raised the subject of Halloween that Maria loved so much, she began playing around energetically again. to Maria. Those marshmallow jack-o'-lantern candies that her mother had bought for her were probably a treasure greater than any other. It seemed that several of them had been bought for her, and she demanded trick or treat from every person she met, giving them candy instead of the other way around. That's so cute.
Maria wa douste konna ni Halloween ga suki nan daro na. Nihonjin ni wa hitotsu najimi nikui ibento da to omottetan da ga.
そう、行列で練り歩く子供のお祭りだからじゃねえのか。普段と違う格好をして、はしゃぎ合うってのは楽しいぜ。多分僕はもう少しディープな理由による、ものだと思うな。何しろ魔女のマリアちゃんだからね。そういや、飛行場でもマリアは仮装するなら魔女になりたいって言っていたっけ。マリアって魔女が好きなんだ。
ええ、大好きよ。困ったくらいに。まあまあ、あのくらいの年頃はファンタジックな存在に憧れるもんですから。せめてテレビアニメのヒロインに憧れるくらいなら可愛いんだけど。What's
not cute about witches? Judging by Rosa's reactions, it seemed that as a mother, she did not find her daughter's love for witches pleasant. Seemingly, all the cousins other than Battler were able to understand this, and they shrugged their shoulders, smiling awkwardly.
うん?魔女好きだと、ハロウィンも好きになるって論法なのか?わかんなきゃ、本人に聞けばいいか。おい、マリア!ハロウィンと魔女って、何か関係あるのか?
As Battler asked that, George and Jessica let out a small, noise. It seemed that they were too late. It almost looked as though Maria had been waiting for that question. After looking happy for an instant, she now looked so smugged. Her expression turned a little mean, as if to say, "You don't know anything, do you?" No, this expression really is kind of smug. It was the expression of an enthusiast who had been enraged by the ignorant statement of an outsider with a wrong impression.
ケルト人は1年間を通じてその勢いを変える太陽は1年を通して
生まれ、育ち、老いて死んで、そして再び蘇ると考えていたの。納得だな。春の通い、ポカポカした太陽がどんどん成長して暑いくらいになり、次第に痩せ衰えていく様をなるほど太陽の一生と考えるのもうなずけるぜ。Ah,
I see it.
だから彼らは10月の最後に太陽は死に、死の国で体を休めて、冬至の日に再び蘇ると考えたの。It's
now October, so the sun has died? Or is... No, it's the beginning of October. So the sun is gonna die.
それで太陽が1年の生涯を終えて死ぬその日を大晦日、サビンと呼んでお祝いしたの。
再び日照時間が長くなり出す冬至の日を太陽の復活の日とする考え方はとても面白いよね。古代の人々がいかに太陽を神聖視していたかがわかるエピソードだよ。で、それが魔女とどう関係があるんだ?
It seemed that my casual urging for it had slightly infuriated Maria. She glared at me with eyes that told me to let her explain without interrupting. Maria looked like she was having fun telling me, so I decided not to interrupt.
10月と11月の狭間は生と死が最も近くなる。ケルト人たちはこの時期に生者の世界と死者やこの世ならざる者の世界が最も近づき、異界の住人たちがたくさん訪れると信じてたの。 日本でいうお盆みたいなものだよ。<笑>
At the time, the people believed that the souls returning to the physical world would go into people's houses or possess people to do bad things. So in order to avoid harm from them, the people invented protective rituals. One of those was to imitate creepy monsters and scare the souls instead, which was apparently a way to avoid being possessed.
その部分がお祭りになっていて、仮装行列になってったんだな。マリアは本当に物知りだぜ。
ほんまやな。わしもハロウィンに備えな言われがあるなんて知らんかったわ。
しかし、それのどこにお菓子をくれなきゃいたずらしちゃうぞってのが出てくるんだ。
Her knowledge was so extensive that the adults had started listening in, too, at some point. Maria, who was normally always treated like the youngest, puffed out her chest in pride. Rosa tried to say that this was just a kid's story, and that she wanted to quickly break up the circle and set the luggage down in the guest house. But nobody else agreed, and she let out a heavy sigh. Seems like Rosa really doesn't want that spotlight on Maria. For reasons.
Oh, trick or treat は単なるお遊び。本来のケルト人たちの儀式とは何の関係もない。それは後にキリスト教の習慣が混合してできたものなの。
That's interesting.
でもマリアは本来のハロウィンの姿とはそうあるべきだと思うの。
According to Maria, the souls of the dead weren't the only ones who visited from the world of the non-human. There were also spirits that had an intimate connection to how people lived. It was because humans received favors of those spirits that they were able to earn a wonderful blessing. And a year's worth of good crops.
つまり、ハロウィンってのは収穫祭の意味も少しはあったわけか。
なるほどな。言われてみりゃ。10月ってのは季節的にもいろいろ節目って気がするぜ。日本の4月のちょうど反対側だもんな。なるほど。霧はいいかもしれねえな。
うん。そしてね、魔女たちはね、その時期に魔女集会、サバトを開いたの。魔女たちは豊かな恵みをもたらしてくれた精霊たちに感謝し、ねぎらったの。
ハロウィンの仮装は、向こうから来る客人たちの模倣。つまり彼らにお菓子を施すのは一年の収穫への感謝の気持ちがあってもいいわけだね。
うん、ジョージお兄ちゃんの言う通り。
つまりハロウィンはこの世とあの世の交流のある時期ってわけなんだな。それでつまり魔女たちにとってはそういう世界の客人たちと交流できる大切な機会だったと。そう言いたいわけか。
おお、バトラの言う通り。だからね、だからね。
I feel something creepy is gonna happen.
魔女たちや悪魔たちの力が最も活発で盛んになるのが10月なの。きっとベアトリーチェも来てくれる。そしてね、一緒にマシュマロお菓子食べて、マリアも黄金鏡に連れてってもらうの。一緒に魔法のお歌を歌って、魔法の呪文を習って、魔法陣の書き方を習うの。そしてね、ルーンの秘密を習って、早く早くマリアを立派な魔女にしてもらうの。
Oh, no, I'm kind of scared.
あらあら、それは素敵ね。子供は夢があるのが一番よ。ところでローザ。マリアちゃんは今年でいくつになったんだったかしら？
おー、エヴァ。
マリア、もうそのお話は終わりにしなさい。
I can't believe Eva is like this towards her own... Well, I guess I could. I was gonna say I can't believe she's like this to her own siblings as well, but... Well, Eva... Eva is Eva.
気にしないで、ローザさん。女の子なら、誰だって一度は思い描く夢じゃない。
ありがとうございます。でももう、マリアはそういう年を卒業していますので。こら、やめなさいと言ってるでしょ。
Rosa scolded Maria, trying to shut her up before her cheery discussion about black magic earned her the snickers of the relatives.
そいつはなんだかスケールのでかい話だな。ところでベアトリーチェって誰だっけ？なんだっけ？聞いた名前だな。
Battler had been gone for 6 years and had completely forgotten about the legend of the Rokkenjima witch. However, when he said that he didn't know Beatrice's name, Maria's mood, which had been so bright until just now, became sour in an instant. When he saw that, Battler immediately remembered that it was the name of the witch of this island, but the damage had been done. Until Maria's mood improved, many mysterious and fabulous episodes regarding the Golden Witch were drilled into his brain.
もうよしなさい、マリア。ありがとうね、バトラ君。お話に付き合ってくれて。
That's a new expression.
カノン君、お仕事があるんでしょ？
Even Kanon is here?
もう行ってちょうだい。ゴーダさん、みんなとりあえず荷物を置きたがってると思うの。悪いんだけど、みんなをゲストハウスへ案内してくれるかしら。
かしこまりました。それでは皆様、ゲストハウスへご案内いたします。
それでは、失礼いたします。
Led by Goda, the relatives headed off in the direction of the guest house. Their minds on setting down their luggage and taking a quick rest, they didn't notice that Rosa and Maria had stayed in the same spot. Oh no! After watching them leave towards the guest house, Rosa's features changed suddenly. She let go with the hand that had been gripping Maria's arm the whole time. She was holding Maria back. No way Maria would have stayed without following her cousins in. There was a bright red mark there, making it clear how much excessive force she had been gripping Maria's slender arm with. That hand then smacked Maria over the head and pulled her left ear up into the air, pinching it sharply.
魔女の話はするなといつも言ってるでしょうが。それはママとの約束だといつも言っているでしょう。
ママ痛い！ママ痛い！
Oh no.
Halloween, Halloween, うるさいのよ、あんたは。魔女のお祭り？ケルト人が何を、黒魔術が何を、バカじゃないの？あんた9歳よ、9歳。電車であんなに騒ぐから、わざわざ電車降りてまでその蛍光塗料みたいな気持ち悪いお化けマシュマロを買ってやったのよ。遅刻してまであんたに買ってやったのよ。あんた、どこまで私の顔を潰せば気が済むのよ。
As Rosa cursed, she twisted Maria's ear up, making it seem like it was going to snap off. An expression of anguish spread across Maria's face, and she stood on her tiptoes as though her life depended on it, trying to soften the pain on the ear that was being pulled. Rosa suddenly stole the candy that Maria had been holding in her hand. Then she threw it on the ground and stepped on it over and over. To Maria, it was supposed to be proof of her memory of that span of time, however brief, when she had enjoyed going shopping with her mother. But it was being trampled by that very same mother. It was as though a brand was being pushed against Maria's eyes, leaving a mark that could not be erased.
こんな気持ち悪いお菓子が何よ！気持ち悪い！気持ち悪い！あんたがそんなんだから！あんたがそんなんだから！気持ち悪い！気持ち悪い！気持ち悪い！
I think you guys know by now how I feel towards Rosa, and I don't wanna take up so much time of this video talking about how much I hate Rosa, so I'm just not going to.She struck Maria's head over and over again with her palm as she spoke. She didn't hit Maria's face because the red swelling would stand out. this is something very common. they would end up hitting other parts of the body that couldn't be seen. If other people saw that red swelling on Maria's face, they would know that, I mean, not only is she hitting her daughter to that point, but also that Maria is someone that needs to be so-called punished. And then that would look doubly bad for Rosa. In any case, I really hate this. Maria closed her eyes tightly, patiently bearing her mother's violence. No, that wasn't quite it. She kept burying it, muttering that over and over. Rosa's shoulders shook as she breathed, tired from hitting. Maria grasped her hands together, withstanding it, hoping her mother would come back quickly. After throwing those words at Maria, Rosa went off towards the guest house, leaving Maria behind. Maria, unable even to remember that it was all right to cry, kept staring down at the trampled, unrecognizable jack-o'-lantern candy.
Ara, Rosa! Doko itte ta no?
Gomen nasai. Bara ga suteki datta mono de, tsui tsui.
Rosa, 早く荷物を置いてこいよ。
Is no one gonna ask about Maria?
兄貴んとこへ挨拶に行こうぜ。
ん？マリアちゃんはどうしたんや？
At least, Hideyoshi has some sense.
まだ花壇におるんかいな。
ええ。気に入ったバラがあるみたいで、世話をするって言って聞かなくて、しばらくは好きにさせることにしました。
女の子には女の子の世界があったことを私たちはたまに忘れるわ。時には尊重してあげないとね。
そうね。
How can Rosa say this with a straight face?
お気遣いをありがとう、キリエ姉さん。ゴーダさん、私たちの部屋はどこ？
ご案内いたします。こちらでございます。お荷物をお持ちいたしましょう。
結構よ。自分で持てます。ありがとう。
Rosa went into the room that Goda had guided her to. Closing the door somewhat violently, she threw her luggage on top of the bed. Please don't tell me something like Maria's in that luggage, please.She got down on her knees in front of the bed and buried her face in it. For a while, Rosa made as if to shred the sheets with her fingernails, sobbing continually.
Maria-sama, 大丈夫ですか?
Kanon, who had been hiding behind a thicket, appeared after watching Rosa leave. Oh, right, because Kanon stayed in the garden, right? Oh my god.
Heiki da yo.
Maria laughed unpleasantly, but to Kanon, who had seen the whole thing, it looked like she was endearing as best as she could.
その程度の器にはその程度のが入り込む。マリアは全然平気だよ。
Kanon got down on his knees and picked up the trampled candy. It was tragic just looking at it. He thought about dusting it off and returning it to her, but really couldn't do so with it in that condition. As he was at loss at what to do, he met eyes with Maria. No, they didn't meet. Maria was looking at the candy that Kanon had picked up. Right now, Maria's heart was surely the same as that trembled candy which had been crushed into a pulp. Kanon realized this, but he didn't know what he should do.
そうだ。さっき僕がもらったのと交換してあげるよ。
Kanon remembered that an identical candy which he had received from Maria was in his pocket. Maria stuck out her hand. Kanon thought she was trying to accept it, so he held out the candy, but Maria didn't try to grasp it. Then, Kanon realized she was asking him to give it back. No matter how tragic it was, that trampled candy was Maria's. Her mother had bought it for her. No matter how tragic, it had to be this candy. If only it could be made pretty again by dusting it off. Kanon hung his head. Kanon held out the miserable candy she wanted. Maria took it and spoke.
Arigato. 人間には誇りしか払えないけど、魔女には元通りに直すことができるよ。ベアトリーチェなら簡単にね。マリア様はベアトリーチェ様のことをご存知なのですか?
There couldn't be anyone related to the Ushinomiya family who didn't know Beatrice's name, with Battler as an exception. But just now, Maria had told Battler about her proudly. She had spoken almost as though she had been meeting with Beatrice regularly. The inside of the fist Kanon made with his left hand hurt sharply. In the past, a witch called Beatrice had appeared and had tempted him and Shannon. He had always tried to make himself think it had been a bad dream. However, Shannon insisted that it had definitely been a real witch. And then, this summer, the shrine to the local Shinto god had been hit by lightning and had disappeared without a trace in the span of a single night. He had known that Shannon had broken the mirror. And he remembered, too, that upon the witch's departure, she had left him with the words that she would eventually be revived. And now, this girl who had no end of faith in Beatrice spoke as though she had met her. Kanon couldn't suppress a sense of something ominous welling up in his heart. So it seems like Kanon doesn't really know what's gonna happen in episode 1. For a while, Maria remained silent as though she could see into Kanon's heart. As though she was waiting for his memory of Beatrice to come back to him. Then she spoke matter-of-factly.
マリアはね、ベアトリーチェとお友達なの。今日だって会って一緒に遊ぶよ。
And she did. In the evening.
遊びます。うん。遊ぶよ。
The face of the witch, who Kanon had tried to pretend was a bad dream, began to slowly creep into the back of his mind.
お父様は研究で大変ご多忙とお仰せです。残念ながらこちらへはおいでになれないとのことです。やれやれ、こちとら秋の大忙しの中、日程をつけてはるばるロッケンジマまで来てるんだぜ。親父も少しは愛想をよくしてもらいたいもんだぜ。本当よね、南條先生。
本当に研究や機嫌の問題なの？ベッドから起き上がれないくらいに容体が悪いって言うんじゃないの？さて、どうでしょうかな。私の口からは何とも。Yeah,
I can't get it out of my head with what Natsuhi said about how Genji and Nanjo are on their side and how they basically won't let anyone meet Kinzo. Nanjo glanced at Natsuhi, as though he wasn't qualified to disregard Natsuhi when he spoke on this topic.
お父様はますますにご健康でいらっしゃいます。寝たきりなどと失礼極まりない。でも余命3ヶ月なんでしょ？普通に考えれば痩せ衰えてベッドからも起きられないはずよ。
でしょ、南條先生。波の患者ならそうでしょうがな、金蔵さんは並外れた気力をお持ちです。あの気迫にお迎えも恐れて近寄れないのかもしれませんが。それほどまでにお元気なら少なくとも安心ね。そこまで元気ならせめて挨拶くらいはさせてほしいもんなんだがな。
If I could read their minds, inside their minds would be money, money, money.
So you know, Ileba Itade, Kokoroga Yasmaranai to Itsmo Boyakuno Daruga. Kyoda Ichido Mizuirazde, Kotoshimo Zein Kakeru Kotonaka Atsumareta Koto, Yoroko Bojanai Kane.
昨年の親族会議でも会えなかったのよ。血を分けた子供たちが2年ぶりに挨拶したいというのがどうして理解してもらえないのかしら。挨拶の言葉があるのでしたら私どもがお伝えします。それともエヴァさん、何かお父様にお会いして挨拶以上のお話でもあられるのですか？ん？
いやね、何の話よ、もう。予算か、エバ。夏井さん、堪忍な。エバも娘としてお父さんの病状が不安なだけなんや。ちょいと気持ちを汲み取ってえな。Hideyoshi
always a smooth talker.
その通りだな。エバは親父殿が嫁を宣告されてから急に親孝行をするようになったじゃないか。
なるほど。その姿をぜひ見てもらいたいという気持ちもわからなくない。何が言いたいのよ。よせよ姉貴、晩飯までには機嫌を直してくれるよう祈ろうじゃねえか。それに俺たちは到着したばかり。まずは軽く挨拶に訪れただけだぜ。親族会議は親父抜きだってできる。いや、 兄弟で意見を統一してからじゃなきゃ話せねえことだっていろいろあるはずだぜな、秀吉兄さん。そうや、ルドルフ君の言う通りや。わしらが全員顔を揃えるのは年に一度しかない。貴重な時間を大事にし、汚い話し合いをせんといかん。Even
though the tea hadn't even come yet, they were very strong-minded.
でもその前に 本家の素晴らしい調度品に囲まれた客間で、のんびりと紅茶を楽しむゆとりがあってもいいんじゃないかしら。Kyrie's
words seemed to hold some slight admonishment towards all of the people gathered in that place. They all understood, and as they cleared their throats and straightened their neckties, The atmosphere in a room returned to normal for a moment.
Shannon
entered the parlor pushing the serving cart. Everyone decided to slowly enjoy some black tea for the time being. A wonderful aroma began to spread throughout the parlor. Looking at that scene, it would have been impossible to guess that the strained atmosphere which had been there until right before Shannon had entered. Of course, Shannon, who was setting out the tea, probably didn't even notice. Kyrie made a gesture that seemed to laugh at everyone's adult appearance. Rudolph didn't like it when Kyrie took the initiative and spoke at the family conference. I felt that too, in episode 1. It was his worthless male pride. He probably didn't want to look like a weak man taking his wife's advice. She understood that and was doing her best to refrain from saying anything unnecessary. So she separated herself from the circle of siblings, which was good-natured only in appearance, and slowly enjoyed her tea near the window.
Ara, Rosa-san. 兄弟で水いらずなのでは?
ご冗談を?
ごめんなさい。 気を悪くしないで。 うちの夫に呆れてるだけだから。
It seemed that Rosa hadn't been able to keep up the charade of amicability. They had come here to fight bloodily and dirtily, each trying to steal the inheritance from the others. She probably didn't want to pretend to be fellow conspirators at this stage. Or maybe she was still much too inexperienced for that.
だいぶ風が出てきているようですね。枝葉があんなに揺れて。 もう台風が近くまで来ているのでしょうね。今夜あたりからはだいぶ降るのかしら。マリアちゃん、この1年で随分立派になりましたね。そう見えます。未だに自分のお洋服を畳むことすらできないんですよ。ええ、こんなにも愛情たっぷりなお母さんと一緒なんですもの。I'm
sorry, what?
心の豊かな子に成長しますよ。Yeah,
that's what I thought. Rosa was silent. Maybe she was unsure as to how Kyrie meant that.
私なんて母親失格ですよ。You're
right. You're absolutely right.
子に生まれる親は選べない。But
you're right about that too.
あの子がかわいそうで。お互い様じゃないですか。親だって生まれる子は選べない。Rosa
bit her lower lip.
どちらが悪いとかじゃなくて、一緒に生きていくんだという気持ちで、ゆっくり成長を見守ってあげればいいじゃないですか。ローザさんは毎日をマリアちゃんと過ごしてるから、小さな変化に気づかないかもしれないけれど、 1年ぶりに再会した私たちには、その大きな成長ぶりがよくわかりますよ。もし本気で言ってくれてるなら、ありがとうございます。それでは失礼いたします。ご用がありましたらいつでもお呼びつけください。Shannon
bowed politely and left the room. After Hideyoshi and Rudolph watched her go with turned heads, the atmosphere in the room began to revert back to what it had been right before Shannon had visited.
お父様がいらっしゃられないなら、それはそれでできる話もあるというものよ。ねえ、ルドルフ?ああ、そうだね。俺たちははるばるここまで誇りの匂いがする紅茶を飲みに来たわけじゃねえぜ。That's
pretty rude, dusty tea.
よかろう。1秒を争ってお前たちがしたいという話を聞こうじゃないか。やれやれ。
たくましい人たちね。早速始めたわ。
私も加わらないといけないわ。あの人たち、私が主張しないと四人兄弟であることをすぐ忘れるから。
あなたも大変ね。ちょっと言葉を選ばなかったかしら。ごめんなさい。
ううん、気にしてません。こちらこそごめんなさい。私たち互いに娘を持つ母親同士なんだから、もっと交流しなきゃいけないのに。
Daughters? Kyrie has a daughter?
いつも会えば変な話ばかりで。
この屋敷の空気のせいよ。ここの空気を嗅ぐと、いつも私たちはギスギスし合ってるもの。
I remember someone said something about the mansion that makes everyone act crazy or something like that. If I'm not recalling wrong.
ローザさんとは親族会議じゃない席で、一度ゆっくりお茶でも飲みたいわ。銀座に行きつけの素敵な喫茶店があるの。ぜひ今度招待させて。
ありがとう、キリエさん。その時はぜひ。
いやーね、急に空が暗くなってきたわ。まるでこの部屋の人たちが天気を悪くしてるみたい。もうゴロゴロ鳴ってるわ。あら、ぽつりと来たかしら。
There really were small splashes of rain on the glass of the parlor window. It seemed that the weather had gotten worse faster than they had expected. Just then, a silent thunderbolt struck inside Rosa's head, and she remembered that her beloved child was in the rose garden. A normal girl would think about going to the house if the weather got bad. But Maria was different. She would sometimes become stubborn and wouldn't move no matter whether rain or even spears fell from the sky. That's right, I told that kid just stay there doing that forever, didn't I?
Maria!
At this small exclamation, everyone turned to look at Rosa.
Nanda, どうしたんだね。
ごめんなさい。ちょっと表に行ってきます。すぐ戻ります。
なんだなんだ。どうしたってんだあいつ。
Yeah, like Rosa's constant switching back and forth with the violence and then quickly apologizing. I don't think that's normal.
いいじゃない。すぐ戻るわよ。それより始めたら?私たちの本題。
そうね。They wanted to get... Well, no, it just sounded like Kyrie wanted to rush things along while Eva's away.
ローザ抜きでも進められる話よ。話を戻しましょう。
Rosa dashed from the entrance hall into the rose garden. When she opened the door, the wind that hit her was too strong to be called a breeze and told her that a typhoon was approaching faster than she had thought. Just as Kyrie had said, small droplets of rain were mixed in with the wind. There was also the low rumble of thunder. It could start raining anytime. Rosa headed for the rose garden. She headed for the place where she had scolded Maria a short while ago. It was almost lunchtime. The children had been told that they could just come to the mansion at lunchtime. So they were probably in the guest house waiting to be called. Even if Maria didn't come, they would surely think that I had taken her to the mansion with me and wouldn't worry much. After all, she was with her mother, so there shouldn't have been anything to worry about. No, precisely because she's with her mother that there are many things to worry about. Except I was here and had thrown my daughter into the worsening weather outside, all alone.
Maria! Hiro! Hiro, nara henji o shite!
It really was as I thought. She was standing stock still, exactly the same way she had been, in the place where I had scolded her. Held in her hand was the candy that I had bought, given her, and then stepped on and crushed. With that gripped in her hand, she had been standing there, as a strong wind whipped her hair about, tormenting her.
につねられたけど我慢して、ママが帰ってくるのを泣かずに待ってた。マリア、ママを許して。ママを許して。ママは悪くないの。また悪い魔女に取り憑かれただけなの。だから平気。ママ大好き。愛してる。
Rosa buried her face in Maria's small chest, crying and begging for forgiveness. And those tears dripped down again, as they had countless times before. If only the brilliant sun had been shining on the two of them. All of their cares would have evaporated, and they would have felt like they could begin anew. However, what surrounded them was the worsening weather. The strong winds mixed in with the sound of thunder was saddening. Rosa noticed the sound of Maria sniffling. If she stood exposed to wind for too long, she would probably catch a cold.
もうすぐお昼よ。ママと一緒にお屋敷に行きましょう。おう、行かない。どうして?
Rosa thought that Maria had already forgiven her, so she never imagined she would refuse. But that expression on Maria's face didn't look like that of a child resisting her mother. So Rosa wasn't able to understand why Maria wanted to stand still in a rose garden pointlessly as the weather grew even worse. Maria answered that question.
ベアトリーチェがね、もうすぐ来るの。だから待ってるの。
Maria?
Rosa started to say something, faltered, and then fell silent. They had just gone to great lengths to make up with each other. She chose her words carefully, trying to get Maria to come with her to the mansion without denying the witch outright.
ベアトリーチェが来るの?
はい。さあ、ならここじゃなくてお屋敷の中で待ちましょう。いつまでもこんな風の中にいたら風邪をひいてしまうわ。
Maria pulled yet another sweet out of her handbag, moaning, ooh. Rosa was bewildered, not knowing what to do as Maria started being difficult again. Just then, there was a sudden massive roar of thunder. It was probably a sign. A sign that indicated this island had become closed off by the storm and detached from common sense and reality. Therefore, as of this moment, all common sense would no doubt be useless. The wind blew, even stronger. And in the middle of a blizzard of scattered rose petals, a figure appeared, leaving Rosa momentarily unable to imagine that this was a scene from reality. No, probably it was. It had to be. fantastical. Because that figure was shaped like... Beatrice? That's new.
Beatrice!
She's not wearing her... the dress. Maria dashed over to the figure. Normally, Rosa would scold her daughter if she dashed over to a complete stranger. But Rosa forgot about that, unable to do anything but stand there, shocked.
久しぶりよ。元気であったか?
She patted Maria's head as she said this, smiling roguishly. Rosa couldn't have known the name of the witch, of the woman who was happily spoiling Maria. However, Maria had called to her in the beginning when she had appeared. Therefore, even though Rosa had never met her, and even though she hadn't named herself, Rosa was able to learn her name. However, that name held a special meaning on Rokkenjima and in the Ushidomiya family. There's no way something so stupid could...
Beatrice! Happy Halloween! Ara, katta no! Beato ni mo ageru!
Happy Halloween. これをわらわにとな。天国にも地獄にも行けず、煉獄の闇にてさまよう男の唯一の明かりも、こうして歌詞となれば実に可愛らしいことよ。人の世とも、人ならざる者との世とも切り離された今のこの島で、これほどふさわしい歌詞はないかもしれぬな。
So this island can no longer be accessible. Therefore, Beatrice is the 19th person. I have no idea.
Maria, それはどうしたのか?
The witch noticed the sweet that Maria has been grasping. It was Maria's candy, which had been stomped on by Rosa, and had taken on a pitiful shape. I realize they all call her by that name. Is it a nickname? Maria deliberately didn't want to say that it was a mother who stepped on it. However, when the witch saw the candy, for some reason, she looked at Rosa and grinned. A chill went down Rosa's spine, as though she felt that this gaze could see through every part of her. Maria held out the candy gleefully. Rosa could do nothing but watch this unfold, stunned. How could this person gloss over the fact that the candy was pitifully trampled in a way that could satisfy Maria? Maria looked as though she believed that it could be fixed as good as new. There was no way that could be done without real magic.
これはこれは見事に潰れているな。さあさあマリア、目を閉じて思い出してごらんなさい。
Along with those strange words, spoken as though singing an improvised folk song, the witch drew the sweet into the air. Maria had her eyes closed, just as the witch had told her, and was focused on remembering the shape that the crushed candy had really been. Therefore, only Rosa saw that scene. The sweet, which had been thrown into the air, burst into a gold color. No, there were golden butterflies. It scattered into several golden butterflies, and they began to assemble in the witch's hand held up to the sky. And when they had, unbelievably, the candy had returned to its beautiful original form, just like the time it had been bought. Only Rosa and the witch had watched that scene. Unable to understand the event that was occurring right in front of her eyes, Rosa stood with her mouth open, forgetting to shut it.
もう目を開けてよいぞ。受け取るがよい。これでそなたの歌詞も元通りだ。
ベアトリーチェはいつもすごいすごい。
There was a very bold contrast between Rosa's shocked appearance and Maria's innocently joyful one. Was that what the witch was laughing at? A smile floated to Beatrice's face, different from the one that she had shown Maria.
わらわの顔が何かに似ているというのか?そうまじまじと見られては穴も開こうぞ。
At those words, it hit Rosa strongly. Rosa knew her face. She knew it from the portrait of the witch. But no, wait. Was this mystery woman really?
Maria, この歌詞の代わりに、そなたにはこれを与えよう。
Doesn't this mean that Rosa saw the entire exchange go down and she still doesn't believe that Beatrice was there?
手紙?
The witch pulled a western envelope from her pocket and gave it to Maria. However, when Maria made to open it, the witch stopped her.
ならぬ。それを開けるときはすぐに訪れるが、それまで決して開けてはならぬ。大事に持っているがよい。そなたを黄金鏡へ誘う招待状となろう。
黄金鏡、やっと連れてってくれるんだね。
大事にしまっておくのだぞ。誰にも見せてはならぬ。
うん、守る。魔女との約束は絶対に守る。
そして、これはそなたへだ。
Wait, I think that envelope is a different one from the one that Maria read out during dinner, right? She probably hadn't imagined that the witch would speak to her, too. Rosa was bewildered by the second western envelope, which had been thrust before her. She has one, too?She remembered having seen that western envelope before. There could be no mistake. It was Kinzo's special envelope, used when he wrote with his own hand and bearing the Ushiromiya crest. Moreover, it was sealed with red sealing wax. And further still, it had an imprint which seemed to have been made by the head's ring. In other words, irrespective of what was written inside,This woman, whom Maria called Beatrice, was trusted enough that she was in charge of a personal letter from the current Ushiromiya head.
四兄弟の誰でもよかった。だが、ここでそなたと出会ったということは、金蔵のルーレットがそなたを選んだということなのだろう。
Oh no. This is confusing.
ならば受け取るがよい。そしてその中身を全兄弟の揃う晩餐の席上で読み上げよ。
Hold up! Maria was the one who read the letter, but now the roles are reversed?
なんですって。
Rosa looked back and forth several times between the witch's face and the envelope she had been handed. Today was a family conference, and the biggest object of discussion was the inheritance problem. So she had joined together with Eva and Rudolph, and they had planned to force certain conditions upon Krauss to try to extort a prompt payment of several hundred million yen out of him. It was as if the witch could see through all of that. And when all of the siblings are gathered, what is she planning on announcing to us? With a personal envelope that no one but the Ushiro Miya head can use.
Maria, 天気が崩れるぞ。ゲストハウスへ戻り、昼を待つがよい。それではローザ、後ほど会おう。その席で改めて。
Now I'm wondering if what's happening here is an alternate timeline instead. But we shall see. The witch turned her back to her laughing and headed off towards the mansion with an air of composure. Maria saw her off with an energetic reply and then dashed off towards the guest house, leaving Rosa where she was. As though she didn't want to waste a second in informing the other cousins of her good fortune at meeting the witch. Ultimately, Rosa was left alone in the rose garden as the winds grew stronger. Unable to do anything except pray that what had happened was just a daydream. When the witch entered the entrance hall, Genji was there. With a respectful gap, cow, no! I saw Genji and Bao next to each other and I went, cow. With a respectful bow, Genji welcomed the guest who approached from the entrance hall.
お待ちいたしておりました。ベアトリーチェ様。
What?
久しぶりだな。Genji. おいたではないか。
どれほどに老いようとも、家具は家具らしく。
晴れの妻が、お前に嫉妬したことも懐かしい。金蔵は元気か。
大変お元気にございます。
The witch's laugh was probably because she knew that Kinzo's own doctor had told him that he would not live much longer. However, if anyone actually looked at Kinzo, his energy and vigor, which made it extremely difficult to imagine that his remaining life really was slim, might make it natural to call him full of life. Maybe the witch had laughed at that.
挨拶に行こうではないか。30年ぶりに。互いに呪いの言葉を吐き合うもよかろう。
It's only been 30 years? As the witch grinned, she started walking, leaving Genji behind. Her gait was like that of a family member who knew the inside of the mansion well. Genji followed her as though he served her. At that very moment, Kirie came out of the parlor.She had probably come out to fix her makeup or something. And when she saw Genji following the witch, she was surprised, although her expression did not change. What? Hold up. I'm just curious whether Kyrie knows of the witch's existence. Does everyone know that Beatrice exists and they're all pretending that she doesn't?There was a visitor for Kinzo, whose remaining life was not long, on the day of the family conference when the fate of the inheritance was to be decided. And furthermore, this person was well enough acquainted with the Ushiro Miya family that Genji was following behind her. Okay, so maybe not. I should have read this first. Kirie immediately realized that this person, who she had never met before, was someone deeply important. Kirie met eyes with the witch.Realizing that it would be rude to pretend not to notice, she greeted the witch.
はじめまして。
ルドルフの5歳だったか。
さようでございます。ルドルフ様の今の奥方様であられます。
From this exchange, Kirie realized that this woman was a guest of considerably high rank within the Ushiromiya family. And the fact that she was a guest of that level, coupled with the face of the entrance hall portrait behind her, made Kirie's eyes open wide in an instant. What? Did that change?
はじめまして。 キリエと申します。 初対面でしょうか? もし以前に挨拶をしていたなら、 名前を忘れてしまって申し訳ございません。
薄々は想像がついているくせに、 わらわにあえて名乗らそうというのか?
Kirie is kind of cunning. Kirie had thought she'd given her a sociable and humble greeting. Her expression grew slightly cloudy at that openly oppressive response. It didn't seem like this was a person she could grow to like. But if Kirie's imagination was correct, this witch likely held a huge key to what her own husband was most interested in. And one that stood a great chance of influencing tonight's family conference. So she did not shoot back a retort and could only watch in silence as the woman went upstairs to the second floor, with Genji following behind. So, when someone tapped her shoulder from behind, she was so surprised she almost choked. It was Natsuhi.
Kirie-san, このような所に立ち尽くして、いかがなさいましたか?
ごめんなさい。 ちょっと魔女の肖像画に見とれていただけです。
黄金の魔女、ベアトリーチェですか? 今日の後宮家の復興は、彼女が授けた黄金がなければ成し遂げられなかったとか。 お父様らしい、幻想的なお話ですね。
Natsuhi spoke of her in her usual way. She spoke from the position that the idea of a witch was just foolish and that in the end, it was nothing more than Kinzo's ramblings. However, for some reason, that no longer felt right to Kirie. Just now, she herself had seen the golden witch come in from the entrance hall and climb up the stairs. So Natsuhi's choice of words seemed almost like a refusal to accept her existence. Or as if she was leading her to think that she did not exist. Right!
ごめんなさい。 少し頭痛がする気がして、ちょっと休もうと思います。
あら、そうですか? なら、良い頭痛薬がありますよ。 用意させましょう。
The hallway in front of Kinzo's study was filled with the scent of sweet poison, particular to that green liquor. Genji, who was completely used to it, did not grimace. And the Golden Witch didn't grimace either.
この中からどれほど出ぬのか。すでに数年になるかと思います。それほどまでにわらわをカゴの鳥としたいか。
Is he the one trapping Beatrice here? And if he hasn't left the room for years, then that would mean that the last time Shannon met Beatrice was that several years ago.
Awarena. Sore o negau sonata ga ima ya kago no tori. Shosai no boure de wa nai ka. Sore ni kizukenu to wa.
あなた様と再びお会いする日まではおそらく文字通り亡霊となっても研究を続けられるでしょう。愛か狂気か妄執か、それも講じれば魔力となるか。悲しき魔術師よ。
The witch grasped the doorknob to the study. When she did, there was a sound like that of flesh burning and splitting open. It was the sound of the doorknob literally burning the witch's hand.
Beatrice-sama.
Nanda kore wa?
So I guess it's true that she can't go in because of the scorpion?
Mayoke ka. Ayatsume. Konna mono ni tayoranakereba, onogami mo tamotenu
tou no ka. I'm surprised Beatrice didn't notice it herself.
その扉はベアトリーチェ様にはおつらいものと伺っております。私がお開けいたしましょうか。
いや、よい。あやつが勝てば、わらわは永遠のカゴの鳥。あやつが負ければ、愛に狂い、すべてを失った哀れな魔術師の生涯が、笑い草となって残るだけ。もはや金蔵もわらわさえもゲーム盤に並べられた駒に過ぎぬ。あとはルーレットの目が勝敗を分けるだけよ。ルーレットが目を見せるまでわらわと金蔵が再会する必要はない。
The witch looked at her hand, which, although horribly burned, was beginning to heal bit by bit.
あるいは。そのための魔除けなのか。なるほど。それもまた潔し。すべては今や、金蔵のゲーム盤の上よ。気に入ったぞ、金蔵。そなたとのゲーム、楽しませてもらうぞ。わらわに恋焦がれ、すべての生涯を投げ出したローマ術師の最後のギャンブル。
Dareka.
The witch's move. Alright, ending here for today, but I feel like we have a lot of juicy details this time around because, okay, well, one, there's Rosa's and Maria's relationship. We already knew how unhealthy that was, so I won't go into the details, and you already know how I feel about Rosa, but anyway... Beatrice also makes a big move here. We see her give the envelope to Maria and Rosa, but I got confused because in episode 1, we see Maria read the contents out at dinner, but in this second episode, it's Rosa who's given the letter, and Rosa did in fact see Beatrice with her own eyes, but still does not believe that Beatrice exists. It's strange. But at the same time, if I'm not wrong, it was only when it started raining heavily, right? After the cousins came back from the beach and then they went to the rose garden and then Maria couldn't find a rose. That was when she met Beatrice, supposedly. And Beatrice gave her a letter. But why is Maria the one reading out? I think Maria would follow Beatrice's, how do you say that? Orders? To not open the letter until the time is right. But then why would she read the letter that's meant for everyone that was given to Rosa? Many, many questions, but I do believe that they will be answered as we go deeper into the story. The last thing that I want to say, Natsuhi and Klaus, almost called him Klaus, like Santa Claus. Okay, but anyway, Natsuhi and Krauss, very suspicious with Genji and Nanjo on their side. Very suspicious. Rudolph said something kind of weird too. It just kind of jumped out at me because he said that he was going to hell. It may not mean much in that context, but I feel like it might mean something. Then Kyrie, who I thought was a nice person? I mean, well, she is nice, I guess. But she is a lot more cunning than she looks. With the way that she diplomatically handles situations and how she, I guess, backhanded, complimented Rosa, it feels kind of strange. Everything is a bit strange in this episode, for sure. I think only the children are consistent from the time we saw them initially, which I guess is a good thing. I really don't want to see them change into horrible characters because I really do like the children. I hope that they don't end up the same way as their parents. All the parents are kind of bad in their own ways, but hey, maybe that's what being human is. Although, Rosa, there is still a line to draw. But anyway, I'm getting off topic there. I think that's all from me today. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Do you hate Rosa too? No, maybe you shouldn't answer that.